going on here? I don't think the dog has seen Shawn Michaels. He's just taking a leisurely stroll, chewing a little gum.
Yeah.
Hey, I like that.
Tatanka, do you really think you've got a chance at beating me at WrestleMania? I don't think so. As a matter of fact, I can guarantee you, better yet, I can promise you that there is no way you are going to beat me for the Intercontinental title at WrestleMania.
What an arrogant individual. And look at the look on the Kizrov Tatanka. And look at that conceit, if you would. Oh, yeah, yeah. Shawn Michaels, the reigning Intercontinental Champion.
Gentlemen, 1 week away in Las Vegas, Nevada, my guests this week have every intention of being the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Please welcome the Mega Maniacs with Jimmy Hart, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, away from Las Vegas and Caesar's Palace, and of course the Colosseum of ancient Rome. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, you Hulk Hogan, are going to be shooting at Money Incorporated and the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship.
Well, you know something, Mean Gene, now more than ever, we're just 1 week away. I'm aware of how destiny is going to take its course, brother, because just a few short weeks ago, bro, when I was laying in the weeds at Venice Beach, California, and I had Monday Night Raw tuned in for the greatest comeback of all times, I saw what could have been the worst nightmare in my life take place. I saw Money Incorporated run across the ring with a metal attaché case with the speed of a lightning bolt. And as it crashed into Brutus the Bionic Barber Beefcake Blood Brothers' face, I saw what I didn't want to see. I heard what I didn't want to hear. And as I turned my face and I turned back, the emotions ran from head to toe. I chilled, I goosebumped, and I broke a sweat as I stood up, man, and I rushed from head to toe. And when I turned on the automatic pilot in my mind, because I couldn't believe what was happening, I ran to the garage. And when I was out of my mind, I accidentally jumped on Brutus's wide glide. And as I kick-started the brother's bike, bro, and as I ran down towards Venice Beach, I clicked it into fifth gear. And as I took a hairpin turn, I spun off the seat. And as I slid across the white sand, headed towards the Pacific Ocean, I buried my ear in the sands of Venice Beach. And then I heard it, brother. I heard what I didn't want to hear. I heard millions upon millions of Hulkamaniacs praying for Brutus the Barber. I heard the maniacs praying that the steel-tempered titanium plates were still in place. And then on automatic pilot, I kick-started the brother's wide glide one more time. And for 7 nights and 7 days, I rode towards the bright lights of New York City. And as I got there, I was sniffing for the hair tonic. I was sniffing for the bush wax. And lo and behold, as I kicked down the Ramada Inn store on 48th and 8th Avenue, just a little bit north of the Mid-City Gym, I found the brother, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, with his feet propped up on an ottoman, laid back in a lazy boy chair, watching Mo, Larry, and Curly with an ice pack on his nose. Thank God for the big man upstairs, that Brutus the Barber is okay and all he had was a broken nose. Thank God, Brutus.
Mean Gene, you know, it goes like this. I spent 2 days running up and down the aisles of Kmart, picking up that tonic, getting all that hair color together, and getting ready to do a number on Money Incorporated. And then it came to me. Things just aren't even worth it, brother. They're not worth the effort. So I took to the desert outside Las Vegas, chopping down some big nasty-looking cactuses, trying to dull up the titanium steel blades, chopped down a couple of small mountains, and then it came to me, brother. I knew that I'd just throw the scissors away because I'm just gonna yank the hair right out of their head.
You know something, Brutus? I hope you put a bono Rinaldo on both of those dudes. But you know something? Since everything's gonna go so good in Las Vegas, man, I've got a surprise for both of you guys. Just last week, when you saw me hanging off Santa Monica Pier doing some fishing with my bare hands, brother, those two 10-foot hammerhead sharks that I drug up out of the Pacific Ocean, they weren't for snack time, dudes. Those fish were for a reason. I've already taken the chlorine out of pool at Caesar's Palace, and I filled it full of salt water, brother. I got a bunch of sea urchins in there and a few nasty mermaids, brother. And as I throw those hammerheads into the pool, Brutus, you need to help me pry their jaws open, brother, because as I put the world title belts across their dentures, those sharks are gonna have lockjaw, brother. That way, when we throw all the bathing beauties, all the Hulkamaniacs in the pool, those sharks won't be able to touch a hair on their chinny chin chin. And it's me, Brutus the Barber, and Jimmy Hart, Hang 10, all through the straddle of the night, brother, celebrating our victory at Caesar's Palace. The only thing left for the detail man to do will be this. Let's take the 2 cases of suntan oil I've got, and as the sun rises in the east, get all those female Hulkamaniacs, all those beautiful Hulkamaniacs, and make sure, Brutus, that they've got an even tan from head to toe. So Las Vegas, Nevada, and the whole wide world, what you gonna do when the Mega Maniacs run wild on you?
Yeah! Vegas next 30 to be for sale. And see these three walking up the driveway. That'd scare you off.
That'd make great neighbors, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah. You wouldn't have to worry about putting your garbage out. They need it. You just have to keep your house kept in.
Luke Foote and Tiger Jackson.
It's going to be interesting here to see what happens with Little Louie. One-on-one with the Tiger. And by the way, you will be wearing that toga, I'm sure. Either that or you won't be at WrestleMania.
I have to be there.
Well, then you have to wear a toga.
It's the world's largest toga party.
Uh-oh.
There's no telling what's going to happen in this matchup or at WrestleMania. Expect the unexpected. And surely expect the Undertaker and the 8-foot giant Gonzalez to give you a match the likes of which you've never seen before.
And expect the Undertaker to probably be at the biggest funeral in the history of funerals, his own.
I don't know about that.
What about expecting the Hitman Bret Hart to retain the title?
I expect the Hitman to be picked up with a blunt.
Expect the Mega Maniac to become tag team champion.
That wouldn't surprise me. Knowing Hulk Hogan and the momentum he has going, but still you can't count out Money Inc.
You see, the Beverlys are only supposed to lock up with the Bushwhackers and vice versa.
Yes, but whenever Little Louie or Tiger Jackson in there, they can bite you all they want, right? Kobe said the thing about that. Don't get him down, pull his teeth.
Pull whose teeth? Luke doesn't have any teeth. Luke is missing a number of them as well.
No, pull Tiger Jackson's teeth. He's only got three, you know, that's all they have.
What do you mean by that's all they have?
All Mrs. have is three teeth.
Only one in the bottom, one on the top.
Bobby Heenan.
But they're good for opening cans.
One's a
count
little
of two and almost three.
We apologize for the absurdity of Mr. Heenan's remarks if in fact he is offending anyone. What? You're not what?
Whoa!
Did he hit that turnbuckle?
And a big smile on the face of Bo Beverly.
The Beverlys, quite a competitive tag team in every respect,
taking nothing away from the skills of the Bushwhackers, who are unquestionably the most unorthodox tag team in all of the WWF. Look at this from the top rope now.
Nail him. Body inside from the top and down to the cranium of...
Here's a cover now.
Here we go.
One, two.
And, but nonetheless, a tag is made. A legal tag.
Put that telephone down.
What?
We'll call the hotline. Ladies and gentlemen, calling the hotline. He himself wants to know the latest scoop. He wants to know the latest bit of maneuvering going on here as we lead up to WrestleMania.
Would you mind paying attention?
Oh, I like that.
I don't get the attention of Luke. Huh. What a slap that was, huh?
Just a little one.
I beg your pardon?
I'm not the governor.
That's for sure.
Both men down.
Poor Tiger Jackson couldn't even have breakfast this morning.
Tiger Jackson could not have breakfast.
No. He ordered cereal and they brought him milk, but he wanted half and half.
Oh, you're a load of laughs.
I think a lot of people are going to be laughing at you, Bobby Heenan, in WrestleMania when you show up in that weasel toga.
I'm not wearing a weasel toga.
Look at this. Budget House of Fire.
Oh, look at that one.
Butch all over the Beverly Brothers, both of them. Look at Butch. And, oh, look at this. Tiger Jackson, Little Louie. Both Bushwhackers, both Beverly Brothers in the ring.
Looks like two cabbage pets now gone amok.
Uh-oh.
Here it comes.
What a test this is going to be for the big guy, the giant guy. but not as big as the one he'll face Rain this Sunday at Caesar's Palace in the Coliseum.
Well, I'll tell you, he has the Undertaker's number. And saw what he did to him, saw what Gonzalez did to him in the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
But he mauled him, he manhandled him. And the Undertaker had no fight. He had to look up at this giant Gonzalez. If it wasn't for Paul Bearer coming out of that urn, bringing him back, he'd still be laying in Sacramento.
We'll be ready this Sunday to face this guy one-on-one and give an education, perhaps,
well,
to the giant Gonzalez.
If he's not ready, he's going to be taking a dirt nap.
I wonder if this guy fits in the body bag, Brain.
Oh, Virgil's only about 6'1".
I'm talking about Gonzalez.
I don't think you even have to concern yourself worrying about that.
Virgil wisely using the speed and agility. Don't want to let this guy grab a hold of you.
I'll tell you one thing. There were a lot of opponents that refused to even wrestle the giant Gonzalez. Virgil's showing us something here, even getting in the ring.
Can you blame them?
Oh, look at them. Look at the power. That was only a short little shot.
Look at Virgil. Second turnbuckle on the inside. And look at this. He's up on a top turnbuckle. And he's only as tall as Gonzalez.
A little bit taller, but not much. Forget it, Virgil.
I drop kick him right in the mud.
You think Gonzalez can get up that high? He's bringing him down.
Brad, I understand the only problem with Gonzalez, he doesn't have a lot between the ears. It's a little bit thick.
I bet he wears a size 28 hat.
Yeah, I think so, huh? I wasn't referring to that. I was referring to the gray matter, which is so important to be successful here in the WWF.
Definitely, I know that. But I doubt the man understands everything that he has to understand in that ring. Wimpleman will lead him through it. Don't worry.
You think so, huh? You
need to learn your lesson, boy.
Whippleman in the background.
There's only one giant
here in the WWF.
Oh!
What's that, a size 20?
Look at the size of those puppies.
Hoofs.
Hoofs. He probably has hoofs.
Nice move, Virgil between the legs. Drop kick. Finds the mark. But no reaction. Devastating clothesline by the giant Gonzalez, almost tore Virgil's head off.
Wouldn't have been a great loss.
I'm going to tell him you said that. I'm certainly looking forward to that match, as well as all the others this Sunday in the Coliseum at Caesar's Palace. WrestleMania 9. Unbelievable extravaganza.
This is over.
Virgil never stood a chance.
I don't think The Undertaker's going to stand much of a chance.
Oh, I do.
The giant Gonzalez!
I definitely do. Come on, ref, this one's over. Do something, even if it's wrong. Virgil's unconscious.
Virgil's in trouble.
He's choking him out. And the referee's standing there.
What are you going to do? He's almost 8 feet tall.
Well, we're getting some additional help.
See, now Harvey's got to talk to him. Harvey's got to get him off.
Well, I believe Virgil is just about out of it.
Hey, when I can't get you to my coma.
Steiner Brothers, this Sunday, you're going to know what the head shrinker is all about. Steiner Brothers, come prepare. Come to fight. Because we're in there to destroy you.
Get the
single opponent that I've ever, ever stepped in the ring with, they've all walked out of that ring with respect for the excellence of execution.
Looking t-shirt, very nice, well tailored. How much is it?
18.
18.
What?
Get over here.
Just a minute, I'm buying something.
I'll be right there. 18, huh?
This is on vacation.
I have to go over there and conduct this interview, and my money's up in the room. I'll pay you for this as soon as I get back.
You know, Fuji, everybody here in Las Vegas is so excited about this Sunday afternoon, about WrestleMania 9. Even the local people who have literally seen it all here in Las Vegas, they are excited. They are excited for one reason. Bret the Hitman Hart, the reigning WWF champion, is going up against your man, Yokozuna. After what you did last week, Fuji, he's got something to prove, hasn't he?
All Oriental trick. Sign, and then we deliver. Deliver indeed. Bret Hart, you got a taste of the kamikaze bomb. And also, my Yokozuna got a taste of the belt, and got a taste of you.
Mr. Fuji, I want you to remember one thing. Yeah. Remember who always was on your side. Remember, I always said you could do it.
Right.
Think of all that yen.
Yeah.
Think of the millions you're going to make
when he becomes
WWF champion.
Oh.
He never liked you. I always did.
Will you stop? Now that's what respect is all about. Here's a guy that deserves it. WWF champion, Bret the Hitman Hart. Bret, we just relived only moments ago what went down here on the contract signing between you and Yokozuna. The guy tried to maim you, Bret. Are you all right?
I'm all right. All I can say is what you call a heavy experience. You know, Yokozuna, everybody knows that I'm going into this thing a big underdog. And everybody knows that Yokozuna, 505 pounds, has got one thing on his mind, bringing that 505 pounds down on my chest. But it's not going to happen. The excellence of execution is the World Wrestling Federation champion for one good reason, because I am the greatest technical wrestler in World Wrestling Federation history. And I am going to show Yokozuna exactly why I am the World Wrestling Federation champion.
I hope you plan on using another finishing maneuver if you get to that point, because I don't think you're going to be able to put that sharpshooter on. Not with those big legs, big thighs.
You know what this guy's got in his...
He's got a lot of maneuvers, but he relies on that sharpshooter a lot.
You don't know, I don't know, and Yokozuna doesn't know.
Nobody knows, but I do know one thing.
I am the excellence of execution, and I've got all kinds of moves up my sleeve. And Yokozuna, after the 10-minute mark, you're mine.
Hitman got a lot of things to prove this Sunday to a lot of people, including himself. Here's a couple of...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it happens this Sunday in Las Vegas. The one you've been waiting for, WrestleMania 9, that includes a double main event. In one of the matches, World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Money Incorporated, Ted DiBiase and Irwin R. Scheister will be meeting my guests at this time. Led to the platform by the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart.
Standing ovation for the Mega Maniacs.
That's a
Hulkamania, I recall in history, General Douglas MacArthur said, I shall return. And this Sunday, in Las Vegas at WrestleMania, Hulk Hogan, you are returning to the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, you know something, Mean Gene. Everybody knows that the eagle is flying slow, brother, and the flag is hanging low, dude. But when you train, say your prayers, eat your vitamins, believe in yourself, and believe in Hulk Hogan, that means you believe in the youth of America. That means you believe in Hulkamania. And I can't think of a better time than Sunday for the Mega Maniacs, Hulk Hogan, and all my Hulkamaniacs in America to do a 360 and turn this thing around, starting out with Wiping Out Money Incorporated. But you know something, Mean Gene? I want President Bill Clinton to sleep easy after Sunday, brother, because the first thing that the Mega Maniacs are gonna do after we bankrupt Money Incorporated, we're gonna seize all their assets, brother. We're gonna throw them in a semi-trailer, and it's me and Brutus the Bionic, brother, Beefcake, kickstart our wide glide Harley Davidsons, brother. We're gonna hook up to that semi-trailer, and as we drag the trailer from the East Coast of New York City back to Vegas, to LA, and back to Florida, brother, Jimmy Hart will sit on top of that trailer and throw all the money out from Money Incorporated just to ease the deficit for President Clinton. That's something the Hulkamaniacs can take to the bank. Tell them, Jimmy.
Jimmy Hart.
Job is, I'm the detail man. I'm taking care of everything. I got those blinkers and those headlights up the front of those wide glide Harley Davidsons so that those title belts will sit perfectly across the handlebars. And when I climb to the top of Caesar's Palace, brother, and angle all 2,000 of those lights down at the front of those title belts, Hulk Hogan, just make sure that you've got those belts angled at precisely the right angle so all the light will reflect directly to Venice Beach, California, and then straight back to New York City so all the Hulkamaniacs will know that we're on the money. Oh, by the way, hey, you know the old saying, when in Rome, do as the Romans do, brother. I think that we should feed those carcasses of Money Incorporated to the lions.
Brother, the lions are the hungry Hulkamaniacs, brother, and they can't wait. They can't wait for the red and yellow to take over Money Incorporated. They can't wait for the red and yellow to run wild in the WWF. And you know something, Brutus? That's exactly what they'll do, because in this case, the lions are the Hulkamaniacs, and that'll be just a little bitty snack for them. But Hulkamaniacs, in closing, there's one last little bit of factual information I'd like to lay upon you dudes. Don't worry about Brutus Bionic Beefcake's ugly twisted up mug, simply because myself and Jimmy Hart have put Brutus's face to the Hulkamania stress test, brothers. And the first thing we did was we broke down the Brooklyn Bridge. Then I took a bull elephant and I cracked his coconut. And then after that, I finished knocking down what was left of the Twin Towers. And the only thing I couldn't bust up was Brutus's mug, because we tested it like this.
Hey, no, 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 no.
And we tested it every way known to Hulkamania mankind. So what you gonna do, Money Incorporated, when the Mega Maniacs run wild on you?
Oh, Mega Maniacs are ready! I
April 4th, live on pay-per-view, the immortal Hulk Hogan returns. WrestleMania, live Sunday, April 4th, on pay-per-view.
Who will survive?
Scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle.
We are ready for action. And so is Barbarland. Speaking of action, we certainly hope you enjoyed us last night. Because boy, did we have fun out in Las Vegas. Boy, did we have fun at WrestleMania.
Awesome. What a spectacle. The glitz and the glamour was only overshadowed by one thing.
Yep.
A new World Wrestling Federation champion. The yellow and the red Hulk Hogan is once again on top of the mountain, barring an investigation, of course.
Well, 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 Bam Bam Bigelow making his way to the square circle, and you just heard the Macho Man right. If you're saying, what did he say? What he said was that the Hulkster, once again World Wrestling Federation champion. What a turn of events at WrestleMania. What with the Hitman Bret Hart defeated by Yokozuna, notwithstanding the chicanery there, and right behind that, Fuji and Yokozuna issuing a challenge immediately to the Hulkster, and Well,
too bad.
Yeah, the rest is history. In a matter of seconds, Hulk Hogan became World Wrestling Federation champion again. However, you also alluded to a potential investigation,
which is undergoing backlash. Yes, you're right.
And we will hear from Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna, who have protested to WWF President Jack Tunney that this not be an officially sanctioned match. And there is some conjecture about that.
Like I say, too bad. Right here, Monday Night Raw, the day after WrestleMania 9, and I felt good about the evening. Yes, I did.
Virgil, taking it to Big Bam Bam Bigelow here. A very competitive matchup here on Monday Night Raw. Virgil working on the arm. You're going to have to get that big man down, Macho Man.
Absolutely, that's right. But Yokozuna went down. You know, I was eating grapes from the Breast of Virgins, and I think that Fuji and Yokozuna, they're eating sour grapes.
And right there, a big mistake on the part of Virgil.
He didn't slide too far, not far enough. Yeah.
And whoa! Missing.
Bam,
it's
bam.
Bam, bam.
Missed, missed.
Hey, take a look at this. One, two, and almost a count of three.
That's what can happen.
Anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation. Take a look at this. Virgil hanging on. Bam, bam. Uh-oh, has his balance now.
Oh!
Devastating maneuver on the part of Bam Bam Bigelow.
I think you hit it right in the head, Vince McMahon. Expect the unexpected, not only on Raw, but all over the World Wrestling Federation, and it's really wide open now, and you gotta be an opportunist, and Hulk Hogan was an opportunist, and he seized the opportunity, and he got the job done on Yokozuna. Yes, he did.
There was so much going on yesterday at WrestleMania, unquestionably. That WrestleMania, I believe, will go down in the annals of history as the greatest WrestleMania of all time.
No doubt about it, Vince McMahon. And I'd just like to say something right now about the pink and black, the Hitman Bret Hart. Not only was he a great World Wrestling Federation champion, but he's a 1,000,000% friend, and he's a 1,000,000% competitor, and he's got the respect of zillions of World Wrestling Federation fans all over the globe. That away, Hitman.
Speaking of the Hitman, for those of you who tuned in yesterday and saw WrestleMania, you were informed that prior to the Hitman's title defense, earlier that day at the WrestleMania brunch, Lex Luger out of nowhere charged Bret Hart, knocked him unconscious with that controversial forearm, and then later on at WrestleMania, Lex Luger knocked out Mr. Perfect with that same controversial forearm.
The coincidence is happening too many times for it to be a coincidence. And President Jack Tunney, I suggest you spend more time investigating this than the WWF Championship belt, which is all sour grapes from Yokozuna and Mr. Fuji.
Well, Jack Tunney, very, very busy man as of late. And Virgil is likewise trying to power out of this, and you're not going to likely do that against Big Bam Bam Bigelow.
Bam Bam Bigelow making a name for himself in the World Wrestling Federation.
That's for sure.
But there are a lot of big names in the WWF.
And speaking of big names here on Monday Night Raw, our broadcast colleague, Rob Bartlett, is...
Who's that?
Rob Bartlett. You remember him?
I remember him. Yeah.
Unfortunately, Mr. Bartlett...
Whatever happened to him?
Well, he made it out to WrestleMania. But unfortunately, he is still in Las Vegas. Apparently, he did not share the same great fortune and good luck as the Hulkster did. Bartlett apparently staying at a different hotel. I guess he lost everything. And if, in fact, he makes it back next week, which we're certainly hopeful that he will, apparently he's going to have to arrive via the Hound, if you know what I mean.
When you say he lost everything, you mean he lost all his $1.22?
Whatever he had, apparently he was cleaned out. So, Rob, if you're still in Las Vegas, and we're told that's where you are now, we hope you're listening on. We wish you the best of luck, which is not what you had too much of when you were out in Las Vegas, and we hope you're going to join us next week.
Yeah, Bartlett, you're going to have to pay your own bills back there. I'm not going to pull you out of this mess. No way.
All right, now it's Virgil who is in quite a mess, but Bam Bam Bigelow, very, very competitive matchup. This capacity crowd definitely behind Virgil. And the momentum can mean so much to a competitor. Virgil grimacing as the big man, Bam Bam, pours on the pressure in the lower back area.
tell you, it's electric in here right now at the Manhattan Center, Monday Night Raw. But it pales in comparison to WrestleMania 9, the Roman Coliseum,
if you will. I think everything pales in comparison to that macho toga that we saw you in yesterday.
Thank you very much. A lot of people said I look pretty.
Yeah. What about the matchup involving Crush and Doink? All of a sudden, we all thought we were seeing double
vision in the Roman Coliseum, and in
double doink. Oh, look at that! Virgil with a boot to the proboscis. Virgil now.
Bruce the proboscis.
Virgil with high risk maneuvers. That's exactly what he's going to have to do now, going all the way up to the top. A wobbly bam bam. Kick, go for it. A pin, hooks the leg, two, and gets him with the nose. Whoa.
But I'll tell you what, Virgil hooked the leg right there. Very, very.
And now, Virgil, going back, quick left jab. Look at this, connecting in a butter. Oh, my goodness, and Bam Bam does not go down. Bam Bam for the ride now. No, reversal, Virgil to the buckle. Bam Bam running face first. Look at Virgil leaping back. Bam Bam sidestepping, driving Virgil down to the canvas.
Bam Bam's only one of the big guys in the WWF that both have size and speed and experience
and agility.
Seasoning. Yeah, agility.
Now it's Bam Bam who's going up to the top. If Bam Bam connects, this one could be history. Oh, and he does.
That's
awesome. One, two, and yes, he gets him a three.
Bam Bam Bigelow, what the WWF is all about.
Here is your winner, Bam Bam Bigelow.
What a matchup with Virgil and Bam Bam Bigelow. And this is Raw. This is Monday Night Raw.
And she's the reason Bartlett didn't make it back from Las Vegas.
This contest
really?
Is scheduled for one fall.
Wow.
Coming down
here
the
comes, making his debut on Monday Night Raw. Our broadcast colleague on WWF Superstars.
A legend in his own mind.
Lawler.
Now, Mr. Lawler truly believes that flowing through his veins, the blood of royal extraction. Although, apparently, these ladies would just... Let's listen in.
First of all, let me say something to each and every one of you imbecilic idiots. I am the king of wrestling, and I am used to being treated with respect. When I walk down that aisle, you idiots should bow down and kiss my feet.
What a chance.
Hey. They're saying Burger King, I believe.
If I hear one more of you idiots call say Burger King, I'm walking out of here.
Well,
what a whopper.
You hear what I said? If they say Burger King one more time, I'm out of here. I mean it. I'm not going to wrestle if you keep that up.
Look at this.
Hey, that's it.
This is
that's
New
it.
York. Well, oh, don't tell me. Are you kidding me? Jerry Lawler protesting, leaving, and speaking of a protest, let's take you now to Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna.
Mr. Fuji filing a formal protest with World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney on behalf of Yokozuna, claiming he should still be the World Wrestling Federation champion, notwithstanding his defeat of Bret the Hitman Hart. You claim there was never an official contract between Hulk Hogan and Yokozuna. You state the match wasn't even sanctioned. Jack Tunney, you've got a tough decision to make.
This I'm sure that Jack Tunney will take ball. Into consideration the comments of Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna. Africa, and hopefully, we'll get a word from Kim Mr. Tunney's office later on this weekend as to the disposition of this matter.
And his opponent.
Well, I think that you should be happy. The shortest reigning WWF champion of all time. Yokozuna had a cup of coffee in the big time of the WWF.
Yes, he did that all right. Yokozuna. Protesting, and who knows, Mr. Tunney could very well see it Yokozuna's way. You never can tell. We anxiously await word from Jack Tunney. Is Hulk Hogan
the World Wrestling Federation champion, or will he say the match was not officially sanctioned and therefore Yokozuna is still the WWF title holder?
Well, I say bottom line, Yokozuna shouldn't have challenged Hulk Hogan right there.
Well, maybe not, but you don't know whether or not Mr. Tunney will rule that it was a sanctioned match. We hopefully will get Mr. Tunney's decision this coming weekend. Bob Backlund against Kim Shea.
Vince McMahon, let me ask you a question right now. The King Jerry Lawler was supposed to wrestle. Where is he?
Who knows? He could be out on the hotline, the WrestleMania hotline, getting all the official results and comments and all sorts of things. By the way, at the conclusion of this matchup, we will be giving you the WrestleMania hotline number where you can find out firsthand all of the happenings that took place yesterday at WrestleMania. And look at this maneuver.
WrestleMania 9 hotline's got to be burning up those airwaves with all the controversy and all the sour grapes going down.
Kim Shea back in the ring now with Bob Backlund, a former World Wrestling Federation champion. We are hoping that the King Jerry Lawler will return to the squared circle and wrestle before this capacity crowd, and this would be the debut of the King on Monday night. Wow, what an elbow by Kim Shea.
Well, I'm not gonna hold my breath waiting for the King, Jerry Lawler, to wrestle on Monday Night Raw. I don't think that he wants to face this Big Apple crowd anymore tonight.
Kim Shea with a hook and count of two is all he can get. And later on, we're definitely looking forward to the tag team matchup that no doubt will be a barn burner right here on Monday Night Raw. The Beverly Brothers, Bo and Blake, squaring off against the Steiner Brothers.
And I'm excited about this one. This one's going to be hot. This one's going to be, well, let me just say, bottom line, it's going to be raw. Uncooked.
Uncut.
And on something else, yeah. Bartlett, I like that. Sure. It may be okay.
Bartlett. Somewhere, Motel 6, I believe they have color television.
Probably the Motel 2.5.
By now.
Right?
I bet they kicked him out. You think he can afford to pay his room to get out of town?
Well, I'll tell you what, they can't take it in trade, that's for sure, because he's not worth anything.
Bob Backlund shoulders on the canvas, not for long. Kim Shea and Bob Backlund going at it here on Monday Night Raw. Down to the canvas. Who is Kim Shea? What's he look like, Randy Savage?
I have no idea, but I heard somebody saw him without his mask, and they said that he is too raw for Raw.
Too raw for Monday Night Raw.
Better with the mask on than with it off.
Speaking of someone with mask, I wonder if that Luna Vachon, did you see Luna Vachon make her WWF debut in the corner of Shawn Michaels yesterday at WrestleMania? And what a number she did on Sensational Sherry. And from there, we're told that when Sherry was in the first aid room, Vachon came running in there and tore apart all over again.
Unbelievable, because Sensational Sherry is a tough girl. Yes, she is. And hopefully, to think that Luna Vachon is tougher, I don't think so.
Well, hopefully next week here on Monday Night Raw, we will have both Luna Vachon, who many would say might be in use of a mask, maybe Kim Shea's.
Well,
Luna Vachon and Sensational Sherry scheduled to be here next week on Monday Night Raw.
Well, I believe Luna Vachon is a Vestal Virgin, by the way.
Yes, you made that very clear. And trouble here.
What's he gonna do here?
A bridge.
I like it.
Two, count of three.
The joy of wrestling. Page 89.
Here is your winner, Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund victorious. When we return, we are told that on the phone will be Rob Bartlett. Here he comes now. Once again.
Entering the arena from Memphis, Tennessee. Weighing 235.
Come on down here. I hear that chant again.
I tell you, it's not going to get any better. These are all friends of mine right here. I know these people.
You can hear them with the Burger King chant again. Nonetheless, it looks like Mr. Lawler is going to grace us, if you would, with his presence and actually wrestle. Thumbs down for Mr. Lawler. Well, not yet. Let's see what he can do in the squared circle.
It's not tough. Forget that he's a hot dog, too. Put a little mustard on him.
It's a good thing he wasn't at WrestleMania yesterday. He would have been booed out of the Roman Coliseum. The King is leaving.
It's been heralded as the greatest WrestleMania of all time. The World Wrestling Federation's premier extravaganza was a show of majesty, pageantry, and riveting non-stop action. Witness the drama, the intrigue, and the unimaginable as the World Wrestling Federation title changed hands not once, but twice. If you missed WrestleMania before, don't miss it again. If you saw it once, it's worth seeing again. WrestleMania 9, relive the legend, next Monday night, only on pay-per-view.
Well, I guess we're going to try it again.
We're back with more Monday Night Raw.
And scheduled once again.
Approaching the ring,
here he comes.
Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 235 pounds, the King, Jerry Buller.
Well, he certainly knows he's not going to get any respect just by asking for it. He's going to have to do it the old-fashioned way, as they say, earn it.
12 to 1 odds he doesn't make it inside the ring. I know I just came from Las Vegas, but what the heck?
This man considers himself the toughest competitor in the whole wide world and the only individual worthy of being called King.
I got another name for him. Might be a little too raw.
And this isn't the Show Me State, Missouri, but... Oh, wait a minute. Oh my goodness, look at that! Jimmy Powers! Hammering away on the King, Jerry Lawler, who have no alternative now but to defend this. Oh, my goodness!
That punch and that turnbuckle came out of nowhere.
The King, Jerry Lawler's in the ring now, whether he likes it or not. Jimmy Powers from the top rope now and down again into the head. The forehead of Jerry, the King Lawler.
You're going to do a lot to prove you're King of the Ring around the WWF, I'll guarantee you that.
A whip to the buckle. Back out yet another time. Jimmy Powers on a roll, clothesline, and the King, Jerry Lawler, is taken off. Oh, come on. The King is having his problems. Rounding him in, looking over here at you, Macho Man Randy Savage. Uh-oh, look at the Burger King. Right in front of us. Got a lot of guts looking over here telling you to shut up, Macho Man, I'll tell you that.
I'm right here, you know what I mean? You know, that's cool with me either way.
The King, Jerry Lawler, our broadcast colleague on WWF Superstars. Not the first time that you and the King have not seen things eye to eye.
Hey, I've proved I've showed a lot of patience and I'm not even a doctor.
Okay. Standing side headlock. Lawler coming off the rope, stepping over. Powers right back in front. Nice leap frog by Powers, waiting for him. Nice hip toss. And a scoop and a slam.
I would love for Jimmy Powers to beat Jerry the King Lawler right here on Monday Night Raw.
Lawler rounding, looking over here again. He does not like to chant Burger King.
It's a lot nicer than it could be. You got a problem, brother? What's your problem? What's going on, man?
Oh, he has lots of problems. This capacity crowd in unison chanting Burger King. He does not like that at all.
He doesn't like it. Yet. He doesn't realize that I'm the world's greatest problem solver. I could solve his problem right now, but I think Jimmy Powers is going to beat me to it.
Finally, in the ring and competing, whether he likes it or not, the King, Jerry Lawler, against Jimmy Powers. The King has been running his mouth, missing with the right hand. Powers connecting. Oh, right in the mush. Beautiful shot by Jimmy Powers.
Caught him right square in the face.
And the King, looking down this way again. The King, Jerry Lawler, on WWF Superstars. You can hear him boast about how great he really is. And we're taking a look at it here for the first time on Monday Night Raw. They do not like him here in New York City, folks. Much to his protest, he cannot concentrate on the matchup. They're driving him nuts here on Monday Night Raw.
From now on, he's going to have to travel with a psychiatrist, and at $9,000 an hour, that's going to get expensive.
Powers against the ropes. Nice reversal there. Off the rope, the King back. Body drop. Jimmy Powers on a roll.
I think everybody in this building can feel how bad Jimmy Powers wants to beat the King. Ooh, that's going to hurt.
And the King hanging on to the rope. Big smile on the King's face now.
Boy, I hate that smile. I'm telling you. I like when people are happy, but not him.
The King sort of rubbing it in to this capacity crowd, and there's no doubt they've gotten to the King. They have distracted him greatly. Kiss my feet, he's saying? On Monday Night Raw at the Manhattan Center. He wants Powers to kiss his feet.
Not Jimmy Powers, and not one person in this building would do that.
And to the buckle again. Jerry Lawler.
Here's your Burger King now, huh?
And again, they're getting to him.
I like it.
The King, Jerry Lawler. Allegedly one of the great wrestlers of our time, but this capacity crowd has really distracted the King. And, ooh, right on the money with the right hand.
Bottom line, he's good. Now we gotta stop him.
I think he's talking to you again.
Is he talking to me?
I don't think so, no. I think
was he
was
talking to me?
No, he was addressing someone else.
Unbelievable, is he talking to me?
No.
Yeah. And take it easy now, Macho. Take it easy, calm down. Take it easy.
Kind of hard to calm down when it's the calm before the storm.
Jimmy Powers now, whipped to the near side, right above us. And Lawler wants to say goodbye-bye. Here he comes. Oh, right into the boot. Right into the boot that has Lawler rock. To the buckle. And again and again and again. Powers on a roll here. And the King is going to feel like a pauper after that. Off the rope now. Powers sets him up, goes downstairs. Powers with a knee lift. Nicely done.
He's got him right now. I feel it. Yeah, do it, Jimmy Powers. Take him down.
Jimmy Powers with the King, Jerry Lawler on Monday Night Raw. Off the rope and a back body drop. Yeah. Ho, ho, ho.
What goes up must come down, Jerry Lawler.
Lawler favoring his back a bit. Powers now whips him to the rope again, sets him up. No, one time too many. Did you see that?
Big mistake.
Oh, wait a minute. We're watching, all right. Up goes Jimmy. Down with a pile driver. The cover. Oh, look at him pulling the tights. He's pulling the tights.
He's got a handful of tights.
Look at the
smile. Smile is repulsive, McMahon.
Jerry Lawler.
Well, they don't like him here at the Manhattan Center. I can tell you that. Lawler strutting his stuff, victorious in his debut on Monday Night Raw. He would have this capacity crowd bow to him and perhaps kiss his feet.
I'm going to chill out right now, Vince McMahon. I can't stand to hear it, listen to it, or
he's
watch
looking
it.
Over your way right now. That's what he's like. Oh, really?
Get this way.
It looks like the King wants to call a Macho Man out. We'll be back as we continue with more Monday Night Raw. Not so sure, Randy Savage. It seems to me that maybe Jerry the King Lawler's headed over this way. We're back, and Jerry the King Lawler here with the Macho Man, Randy Savage. We couldn't help but overhear a few comments from you when you were having your match there, directed toward the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
You know, you Macho Man, and all the rest of this scum from the Rotten Apple are right where you belong, sitting nice and comfortable in a little chair, watching the greatest wrestler in the world in the ring. It's easy for all of you to run your mouth when you're sitting in your little seat. All of you gutless wonders, the only thing that's athletic about any of you is your feet. And that goes for you too, Macho Man. You don't have the guts to get in the ring with the real King. You understand what I'm saying?
Okay, well, thank you very much to King Jerry Lawler, the Macho Man Randy Savage, who's got nothing but guts.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this WWF event. Gorilla Monsoon, along with his lordship, Alfred Hayes. A matchup about to take place here. Main event material in any arena in the entire world, Alfred.
Yes, and what a test this is going to be for Mr. Fuji's man, Yokozuna. He's coming against probably one of the biggest men he's going to be pitted against.
Typhoon will certainly push Yokozuna to the limit.
Yes, and
looks like he hasn't missed too many meals, does it?
Well, I would say not. Those chaps, they do portray themselves when they're young to grow to such massive proportions.
Two lovely young looking gauges there.
I'd like to see their faces.
Look at that kisser.
Yeah. There's one thing you know, Gorilla, our cameramen take you right inside the ring.
They do. Some of them want hazardous duty pay though, Alfred.
I don't blame them at all. I wouldn't like to get too close to Yokozuna or this chap.
Tremendous ovation here for Typhoon. And a look of disdain as you saw our video wall from Yokozuna.
Well, he's not exactly the inscrutable East, Yokozuna, but he does try to keep all emotion from his face. You'll see that same expression practically all the way through, but there was a look of disdain. You're right, Gorilla. He looks at Typhoon and fucks that. I don't think this fellow's worthy.
Look, I certainly hope they've reinforced the ring for this one.
God. So if that ring caves in, we're all going to go with it, I think. Sucked into a big black hole.
I'll bet you I can beat you back to the locker room area, Alfred. Take a look at this. It looks like perhaps no longer 505 pounds, but maybe 525.
Yeah, see. He's something huge, huge. Right. A little ceremony here.
The dreaded salt ceremony to drive away the evil spirits.
He didn't drive you away, Gorilla. Oh, I'm sorry about that.
Look at this.
You got some salt in your eyes there.
Well, the whole ringside area over here got their complete year's, what would you say, quota of salt in their diet, Alfred.
Sodium, yes. It looks like dandruff over their jacket.
Yeah. Now showing up that he has no hidden object. Why on earth would he need a hidden object? Nothing under that armpit.
Is that what that is for? I thought it was something else, but
no, it's to show that you are carrying nothing.
Very interesting. Of course, you spent a considerable amount of time in Japan.
I certainly did. Made at least two trips over there from 1963 through 1979 every year.
Every year, so
for 9 to 12 to 15 weeks at a time.
Well, I went there for tours for 15 weeks.
Oh, look at that! What a move by Yokozuna as they crash together, the immovable object and the irresistible force. Nothing happened, and then Yokozuna nailed him with a belly-to-belly.
And wasn't that power? Power personified. Typhoon, 400 pounds plus, and Yokozuna really dealt with him most efficiently.
Referee right over in the kisser, Typhoon, questioning him, is he all right to continue?
These huge men.
Well, there's a little distraction there on the part of Mr. Fuji. He does that better than anybody.
He certainly does, and that's where Yokozuna, with a manager like Mr. Fuji, scores so well.
Uh-oh, look out.
Oh, my word. 500 pounds.
Oh. Typhoon just became a summer's breeze.
Oh, gosh, he did indeed. Just a zephyr inside the ring there.
Luna!
Certainly didn't expect this kind of matchup. Certainly expected more of a challenge on a Typhoon. Yokozuna made it look easy.
He certainly did. Well, right in the very beginning here, Yokozuna took away any offensive move that Typhoon may have had in mind with that tremendous trapped arm suplex.
Mr. Fuji certainly has a gold mine here in Yokozuna. After much deliberation over Mr. Fuji's protest on behalf of Yokozuna, it is my decision that there was an oral contract. Mr. Fuji issued a challenge. Hulk Hogan accepted. Furthermore, there was a WWF referee in the ring. Therefore, my decision is that Hulk Hogan remain World Wrestling Federation champion.
All right, folks, I have the messenger, and I've got some great news for you. Here in the tri-state area, Connecticut, New Jersey, and New York, we're going to be out in Uniondale, Long Island, at the Nassau Coliseum, hot on the heels of WrestleMania 9 with World Wrestling Federation action. Saturday night, May the 1st, Mr. Fuji, come on in. Brett the Hitman Hart, by the way, is going to be facing... Oh, Lex, yeah, look, yeah, oh, my yeah. God! Oh, no, he stepped on my foot. Keep this man under control. Oh!
I told you once, and I told you again. I'll tell you again. Yokozuna is very, very disappointing on the outcome of WrestleMania 9.
Well, I can understand that. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, a man that you challenged a number of weeks ago. We know what happened the first time. What's going to happen this time?
First time, as you recall, Hacksaw, you have laid out, stretched out. With your American flag, I covered you head to toe. This time around, you be laid out, but I'll do something better. I go one step ahead. I will lay my Japan flag right on you head to toe.
Thank you very much. Sayonara, Mr. Fuji.
Sayonara, boys. No one there.
Very good, Mr. Fuji. His man, Yokozuna, is going to be meeting Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Pat Riley called me about you this past week. Shawn Michaels, he watched WrestleMania 9, and he saw you personally trash Mr. Perfect.
You know, I would think Pat Riley could really use a cheap shot artist like me on his team. You know something? Did you see Mr. Perfect with his head sticking out of that trash can?
I saw it.
You know who he reminded me of?
Who's that?
It reminded me of Grover from Sesame Street. You know something, Mr. Perfect? If you were so perfect, wouldn't you be challenging me for the Intercontinental title? See, as far as I can tell, I'm the man with the gold. I'm the man with the flawless record. I'm the man that's unblemished head to toe. So, Perfect, if you want some of me, come and get it. You're a two-time IC champ. In my book, that makes you a two-time loser.
Well, I don't know about that. The words of none other than the Intercontinental Champion, reigning Intercontinental Champion, Shawn Michaels, his title defense against Mr. Perfect.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, the encore presentation of WrestleMania 9
introducing first,
will be this
making
Monday night.
His way
once
down
again,
the aisle.
You can see
from
by calling
Kansas
your local
City,
cable
Missouri,
company starts at 10 o'clock Eastern and Pacific.
Pounds,
and I can tell you one
Mr.
thing, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Hughes.
This big man getting into the ring is one tough individual.
And his opponent.
He looks mean, I'll say that for him.
Wisconsin.
Weighing well over 300 pounds is this athlete.
J.D. Stryker.
As J.D. Stryker gets his introduction, there's the bell. We're ready for action. And Mr. Hughes with a very nasty look. And is he going to wrestle with those shades on?
I guess.
That's a little dangerous, wouldn't you think?
I would think so. But it shows you the confidence he must have in himself. Yeah, he can wrestle with the shades on.
He just ran through J.D. Stryker with that clothesline. And hammered him with a straight right hand. Remember, still to come in this broadcast, the return of Hacksaw Jim Duggan. This big Mr. Hughes, very impressive looking athlete, as he takes Stryker up and over, landed him with that slam, and could have pinned him right there. Opponent and executes a violent backbreaker. This guy has got an ugly, nasty look on his face. He is not happy about something. Lateral press, and once again, he refuses to pin his opponent.
He's very, very agile for his size, especially when there was street clothes on, sunglasses, suspenders, a tie.
Right hand He is a very physically dominant athlete who has certainly controlled this one.
Ooh.
Kicked him right in the ribs, does Mr. Hughes on J.D. Stryker.
Looks like a guy that would collect if you were like a car payment short. Maybe a half hour late.
I would imagine he has some very strong persuasive powers. Oh, good flexibility.
Well, see, I'm not the average guy that makes payments. I pay cash for everything.
Oh, I'm sure you do. Well, I've made a few payments in my time. Bought a pickup one time on time.
Don't give me, don't talk that Oklahoma.
Tremendous slam. He hooks the leg. And very impressive victory for Mr. Hughes.
You bought a pickup truck?
Trucks in my time, as a matter of fact.
Look at this, Ross. Kicks him right in the mush.
Right in the face.
And keeps his balance. Well, watch how he manhandles this man. Look at this. Just drives him into that mat. Oh, yeah.
Very impressive outing for Mr. Hughes. Tillichai, much more.
You got a pick.
Jim Ross and Bobby the Brain Heenan back with you here for more WWF action.
Scheduled for
and as the Beverly Brothers and Little Louie make their way to the ring, I'll never forget seeing Bobby the Brain Heenan just last weekend holding on seemingly for dear life on this camel. It was something I'll never forget.
The worst day of my life. I was supposed to be taken out of the sedan. Girls feeding me grapes, fanning me. They hooked me up to this 9,000-pound wild attack camel.
Attack camel?
You noticed it too.
I didn't know that you had such a fear of animals.
I don't like camel. I wouldn't smoke.
You wouldn't have done well on the farm.
Of course not. From Beverly Hills. I don't have anything to do with farm animals.
Well, speaking of farm animals, and just about as crazy as some that we have seen, they are popular, no doubt about it. But the wild and crazy bushwhackers on their way to the ring was their buddy, Tiger Jackson. He looked good on the camel, though, you know. Jackson got a pretty nice haircut there.
What a lot of people don't know is Tiger Jackson, right there, is the first daughter of the Bushwhackers.
Would you please repeat that? I didn't really quite get that.
That is Luke and Butch's daughter.
Daughter?
That's what I hear. Or their older sister.
Well, this one will be unorthodox, to say the least. I don't name any official in this match either. As if Little Louie has a little size advantage, but not much.
But it looks like Tiger Jackson's a lot quicker. Matter of fact, Tiger Jackson looks like a cashew nut.
Tiger Jackson with a little sleight of hand. Speaking of sleight of hand, two going to clowns, and I don't care what you say, I saw two clowns.
When you stay up late in Vegas, you'll see pink elephants if you stay up late enough. I'm telling you what it was. It was just an illusion, like Siegfried and Roy do. It's a magic trick. There's only one doing.
Well, I don't believe that. I think the fans that saw WrestleMania certainly would not agree with that either. And Tiger Jackson seeking some relief there in the bottom turnbuckle.
I believe he was munched upon. Favorite dessert is?
Shortcake. I had a feeling you might say that.
You know what his favorite seafood is? Shrimp.
Jackson. Putting his slightly larger opponent down. Little unique assist there by the referee.
Throw him over here. I'll play catch with him.
He'll probably drop him on purpose.
Accidents do happen, Rod. The world's smallest Chippendale dancer.
Face lock applied, and the referee getting a little bit of kind of stretching the rules. There's that young man, the Tiger Jackson.
You know, if I bit that referee, I'd be fined and suspended. If I shoved the referee, I'd be out of the WWF.
Again, the front face lock, and again, Tiger Jackson slapping the referee, and the referee thinks it was Little Louie that was the perpetrator.
Tiger Jackson, dummy.
And you can certainly trust the Beverly Brothers. They've never told a lie or done anything illegal in their life. Well, you're the kind of guy, you know these guys. You guys are from the same part of the country.
Well, they're good friends. I mean, they're from Ohio. They're from Shaker Heights outside of Cleveland. But they're wealthy. They're just nice people.
Pace quickens there a little bit. Oops, you turn there by Little Louie, and Tiger Jackson got tripped.
It's like a Nintendo game.
I'm not sure. Brain, you're the analyst. What do you call that one?
That's a head spin.
Oh, the old head spin.
The old head spin.
Well, Louie has Tiger Jackson on his shoulders for that small airplane spin. A little bit dizzy. Trips back over his opponent.
Come on, ref. Get Butch out of there.
There's an illegal assist by
Come
Butch.
On, ref.
And it's going to work.
That's not fair.
And the Beverly's down. And the Bushwhackers hooking it up. The Beverly's on the outside. And the Bushwhackers are marching to town.
Look at this. They've all gone nuts.
Jackson.
Well, we said it was going to be unorthodox.
What's got 19 and an IQ of 11?
I don't know, Frank. Tell me, what has 19? What's 19 teeth and an IQ of 11?
The Bushwhacker and Tiger Jackson combined.
What do you mean? Well, a little unorthodox, as we mentioned, but they were victorious in this contest.
They cheated. Came in and threw that little cat shoe on that other little hillbilly. I hate Mitch.
Here it is, guys, just like I promised. Now tell us everything you know about
Don't
the Steiner.
Don't worry, it's tax-free.
Let me tell you something. We wrestled the Steiner Brothers right here last week on Raw, and they think they're unbeatable, and they're not.
Well, what about that double arm suplex?
Oh, their suplexes are devastating. Uh-oh. That's why you gotta take their legs out right from the get-go, right from the start.
Are they as fast as they look?
They're fast. Look out for that Scotty especially. He's quick as a cat.
And I'm telling you, they're strong. They're really strong. Oh, but their baby, their main move, their finishing thing is that Frankenstein.
Let me tell you, about that? Don't let it happen. If you get caught in that Frankenstein, you're done.
Well, how do you stay
over?
All right, we're back with our Monday Night Raw, and yes, Money Incorporated is standing by. However, before we go to Money Incorporated, next week here on Monday Night Raw, scheduled to join us will be the Hitman Bret Hart for a special interview. Virgil squaring off against Razor Ramon. Easy for me to say, what a matchup.
It's going to be hot, the Hitman, right here on Monday Night Raw. Right. But ask these guys a serious question.
Let's go now. Money Incorporated scheduled to join us. And gentlemen, can you hear us?
Yes,
yeah, we what about it? You don't seem happy at all. Next week, the Beverly Brothers challenging Money Incorporated. What about it?
Challenge Money Incorporated like we're supposed to run away scared. Yeah, we accept your challenge.
Right here. What's the advice?
We have faced everybody. We beat Hulk Hogan and Beefcake.
Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. They're going at it, Hulk Hogan.
Here Brawl.
The Beverly Brothers. Money Incorporated going at it.
Well, this is what we have been awaiting this week.
Bam!
Here it comes, our creature matchup.
Bam! Bam! Bigelow!
Talk about a mean dude and a big dude. He's on fire, all right.
Here it is.
Flaming hot.
Bam! Bam!
greater speed than Bam Bam? You're talking about Owen Hart now?
Yeah, I think
you
got it. The Rocket. Go ahead and answer the question.
You're talking about that kid from the Hart family, the one that's the brother to the Hitman, Owen Hart?
You got it. Former WWF champion, yeah.
You think that he is more agile and is faster than Bam Bam? Just watch what takes place here, and you will change your feeble opinion.
Bam Bam versus the Rocket. There he is.
Bam Bam can do that.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I see.
See, points, just like it.
You can do a lot of things you don't show us, too, I guess, huh?
Yeah, right. Before it's over, I'm going to show you a lot of things, too.
Yeah, don't let anything stop me.
We'll look forward to the King showing us. We hear the King a great deal, and you can see Bam Bam. Oh, top kick by Owen Hart right away.
Didn't even phase him.
Owen Hart with the right hand, a series of them now. Bam Bam Bigelow against the rope. Owen Hart trying to set up the big man. Reversal. Owen Hart off. Bam Bam up high.
Put on the brakes, Owen. Oh, there's some agility.
You're right. That was awesome.
I'm glad to hear you admit when you're wrong.
Wow.
Impressed.
Bam Bam hammering away on the brother of the Hitman, Bret Hart.
You guys have been brainwashed that this whole Hart family is tough. Of course, you guys could be brainwashed with an eyedropper. But let me tell you something about the Hart family. These, you know, what Bret and Owen, when they were growing up, they were the bullies of their neighborhood. They were tough around the block. They could beat up any kid on a block except the Smiths.
The Smiths?
Yeah, they were boys. Brothers, they don't impress me at all.
Owen Hart on the top rope, and kick, and Bam Bam is impressed with that maneuver.
Keep going, Owen, even though the King's not impressed, keep going.
Owen Hart off the rope, over the hill, trying to hit him, and he hit him in the
rope.
That's right. Owen Hart helping the Rocket.
Owen Hart working on the rest of Big Bam Bam Bigelow. And the big man is down.
And Bam Bam is hurting. Tell you what Owen Hart had better not do. He had better not make the big man mad.
And a slam. Elbow missing. Owen Hart, thus far, too quick, yes. And far greater agility, as was said before.
Not far greater, not far greater.
Somewhat greater, Ben?
No.
Bam Bam seems to be dwindling right now.
Yeah, sort of sizzling out a little bit at the moment, at least.
Maybe the Rocket's going to dump a bucket of water at his head.
Now, what's going to happen is he's going to light that short fuse of Bam Bam's in a minute, and then the only Rocket you're going to see is that Owen Hart being lit up and flying around the top of that arena.
Well, he can fly. No doubt about that. We saw him flying earlier on from the top rope to the dropkick.
Ooh, look at that.
Yeah, Bam Bam using his head as a battering ram.
Oh, there's a dropkick for you.
On the outside, Owen Hart collecting himself. Bam Bam's coming right out there, Woody. Bam Bam ramming up to the apron. The matchup will resume when we return with more WWF Superstar. We're back with more WWF action.
And Bam Bam Bigelow has been doing a masterful job of keeping Owen Hart out of the ring.
He's definitely the master of disaster right here in Superstars. Yes, he is.
A nice shoulder block. And over the head, over the whole body, the Rocket Owen Hart behind Big Bam Bam, trying to get him down.
He can't get him down.
Bam Bam,
boom. Now, he got him down all right, just not the way he wanted him down.
I give credit to the Rocket Owen Hart. There's about 7 different times where another guy would have quit, wouldn't have had it in him, but the Rocket keeps fighting.
And Bam Bam Bigelow, unrelenting in his attack on the Rocket Owen Hart.
Uh-oh.
Bam Bam, what's he gonna do?
Oh my goodness, look at that.
Give me a break.
He's got 42 ways of disassembling a rocket.
That's exactly right. You know, Bam Bam is proving that he is just as agile, he is just as quick, and he is much, much more powerful.
Bam Bam hammering away almost at will now on the Rocket Owen Hart. And I must say that the Rocket Owen Hart has really been impressive in this matchup, and I'm not too sure. He came down on his knee, I believe, from way, way up there. Yes.
That's it. Throw in the white towel.
The Rocket Owen Hart, very impressive in single competition. We have seen him in a tag team before.
And Bam Bam continuing to apply yet more pressure. Moving in.
Look at the Rocket keep fighting. It's not over until it's over.
And if any family knows about perseverance, it would be the Hart family.
A whole family of losers.
A whole family of winners.
Yeah, right.
Perhaps that family having more respect in the World Wrestling Federation than any other. And look at this. Out of the bear hug, Owen Hart trying to work to the inside. Has a way up. Look at this. How about that?
It's over. Well, it's over. The only one that doesn't know it is Owen Hart.
And he still won't know it.
Oh, my goodness. He knows it now. He knows it now.
You might be right, but I don't think so. Not until I hear that three count. Bam Bam, he's a tough guy with the Rocket.
And a headbutt follow-up there with Bam Bam Bigelow.
Covering Bam Bam, you got it.
Oh,
and
not
a sloppy cover. And
still kicked out. Still did it.
Prolonging the agony. That's all he's doing.
It's all right.
I'm not so certain.
He may end up winning the match.
Yeah. And Owen Hart whipped to the far side. No. Wait a minute. I think there.
I'll tell you, Vince, he hurt that knee earlier. I think he's throwing out guts alone.
I think he blew the knee right there if he didn't blow it earlier.
I think he's just running on guts. Oh, he can't even run.
He's not running anywhere.
Oh, but nonetheless, moving out of the way. Bam, Bam, Bigelow having his problems. Owen Hart perhaps having even more severe problems with the knee.
Come on, Bam Bam, work on that leg.
Work, what do you mean? Work on the leg?
Certainly.
I've got chills. The Rocket is just unbelievable fighting against all odds.
Bam Bam going up to the top. The Rocket is
Ooh, he got him.
And that should do it.
You have to take chances when you're in there against a competitor like Bam Bam.
Let's go back and take another look.
Give Bam Bam some credit. Look at
that. Owen Hart, the Rocket. Oh, see, he came right down on his knee. Vince, yeah, you're right, right there. And now, look, he tries another high risk maneuver, but he can't make it. Guts. Guts. The Rocket's got guts, King.
He's got
something
guts
you don't know about.
He's got guts, but no brains.
This match. I know Money Inc., who is on the card, they're in the back on a monitor watching it. Shows you the importance of this match. Everybody wants to become WWF Tag Team Champion.
Bo Beverly was on your left there. Blake, the taller of the two on your
both
right.
Both the blonde.
They're both blonde.
See? And there's only two of them.
Money Incorporated, IRS, and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, watching this match. We'll see them in action later in this hour.
And the Steiners are in the building. Why would they be here if they're not wrestling? See the importance of this match? Everybody wants to see, because things can change so quickly here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Referee trying to get it one-on-one here, the early going of this contest. Lex Luger will be here.
Oh, yeah.
El Matador still to come. And the Nasties certainly getting the crowd involved here in the early going.
for the Nasties against... That is Bo. Are you sure that's Bo?
Are you sure that's Zag?
Yeah, I'm sure it's Zag.
I'm sure it's Bo.
I think that's Blake.
That's not Blake, that's Sags. How many Sags do you see out there?
Oh, we're going to go with the clown thing again. How many Sags are? There's one Sags, there's one Knobs, there's one Bo, there's one Blake. But there are two doing the clowns.
Then that's six.
Ask Crush. Ask Crush how many Dork the clowns they are.
He's from Hawaii. He can't count past three.
Yeah, wrong. Collar and elbow tie up here. Sags forces him back into the corner. Here. Nice counter move, reversal, hit by takeover. And a clothesline. And down goes Blake Beverly.
Going back to make that tag, he's going to cut that ring in half. Talking about Bull.
That is made. Ryan knocks in, and he catches Beverly with that clothesline. Lateral press and a near fall.
Boy, I sure hate to see the Beverlys involved in a pit stop. Well, that's when they raise their arm.
Wristlock applied by Knobs, thumb right to the eye, and a tag has been made. Hit by takeover, and scoops him up. Does Ryan Knobs? Ooh.
Look at that!
Yeah, that sounded like a car
wreck. He'd have his seatbelt on, I wouldn't have saved him.
Knobs, referring to the Beverlys as Beverly.
Well, all you're going to do doing that, Knob, is you're going to make the Beverly Brothers mad.
That's Bo Beverly, right?
That's Blake Beverly.
Are you sure?
Yes, he's the blonde. Bo's the one on the apron. That's two Beverly.
Well, he wants to make friends now.
Back into the face. There you go. Ooh.
And that just fired up Knob's right hand. Back to hook the leg, couldn't quite execute that pinning predicament. Good Jerry Sags. Back in the ropes, down the corner. Referee calling for the break, but we do not get a clean break. Irish whip, far side. And nobody there this time.
See, the secret with the Nasties, you got to get them down and you got to make quick tags. You got to wear them out. You don't stand up and fight them. They're real big, tough, rugged men. So you gotta get them down. They can wrestle, they don't know a hammerlock from a padlock. So you gotta get them down and kick them.
That's a rather debatable point. I'll have to agree that they're great brawlers and great street fighters, but I've seen these guys execute some outstanding wrestling maneuvers from time to time.
Yeah, like running a man's face into your armpit.
Oh, cheap shot on the outside. Bam, this tag team confrontation will continue. I'm out.
Kick him! Kick him!
Blake Beverly continues to hammer away. And Brian Knobs, Jim Ross, and Bobby the Brain Heenan back with you. And this is quite a tag team matchup, Paul. What a rich whip.
See, you gotta keep him down now. Get him back in your corner. Fast tag. One takes the referee's vision away. One makes the move. Back in tags. Turn the referee back and forth. That's how a good tag team operates.
Tag made. Blake Beverly tagging his brother, Bo. And both coming right off the second rope, the double axe handle right to the spine of Knobs of the Nasty Boys. And as we said earlier, this match very, very important in the WWF Tag Team title picture. And what velocity in that Irish whip.
And he's down. That's where you want him. But you want him down in your corner. Look at that. Spinning on the mat. What a slob. Excuse me.
Bobby, please. What? Double teaming by the Beverleys, proving very, very effective here. And more double teaming. Oh,
Vince. Now, that'll hurt a lot more tomorrow morning than it does right now.
I'm sure it hurts a lot right now. Maybe all. He hooks the near leg. Got a near fall out of it.
He's getting a float. He's favoring his back.
With a tag made, the Beverleys make another exchange here. Scoop him up, but his back was obviously is bothering him there. He could not get his opponent up. Front face lock. Knobs trying to block the what looks like an attempted suplex here. And tatters it with one of his own.
But I think that hurt Knobs more than it did Blake Beverly.
Both teams need to make a tag here. There you see. A tag with his brother, but oh, outside goes Knobs. Ryan Knobs in a great deal of trouble here.
See what they should be doing right now, both of them on the floor, both Beverleys, pick up Knobs and run him backwards into the post. Rearranges the whole spine. Good Greco-Roman posting move.
Beverly brothers certainly seem to be gaining the offensive advantage here in this tag team confrontation. And Knobs again. Oh, he's dropped him with steel. They dropped him face first. Right over the steel did Blake Beverly. And I'm not so sure Knobs is going to be able to recover from that.
I think they knocked some teeth out. Big deal.
Knobs.
Beat him now. Just beat him. Kick him, stop him, and beat him. Here we go.
Again, lateral press and hooking the near leg.
Got some fight left in him, but he's just running on fumes.
Our Nasty Boys are tough. They certainly will not quit.
But not smart enough to quit.
Well, attack made. The Beverly Brothers make the exchange. Blake Beverly. Irish whip. Oh, he lowered his head a little bit too early.
Too much, you're right. He caught him just right too. Now he's going to make that tag to both.
And now let's see if Knobs can tag in Sags. Knobs has been there a long time.
Come on, Blake. Make that tag. He's got it.
Let's make the tag. Let's go to the next one.
Oh, put the brakes on him.
See the Nasty Boys get the Duke.
You two bleach blonde morons think you're gonna bankrupt Money Incorporated when the mega maniacs couldn't do it? Who are you fooling?
You're gonna find out when you cross Money Incorporated's path, you pay the price. And Beverly Brothers, tonight, you're gonna pay.
Money Inc., tonight, right here in front of everyone, we're gonna show you how much you're worth. We're gonna bankrupt you right here on Monday Night Raw.
Sensational one! Our history is rich with pain and mayhem, violence and evil. At WrestleMania, I walked down that aisle of princess, Noah goddess, and you had to put your nose into my business where it never belonged. I beat you to the ground. The pain, and the anguish, you're mine. It didn't stop there, oh no! I hunted you down and found you beaten at the first aid station. And then you truly witnessed my fury! Last Monday night on Raw, I tore at your flesh. I tore at your clothes. I tore at your very soul.
Ring of the Shine, trying to rip Sensational Sherry's clothes right off.
Oh no.
Sensational one, from this day forth, I will haunt your very breath. I will be your shadow in the darkness. And then soon, very, very soon, I will wipe you from this earth. And I, Luna Vashon, I will be the goddess of the square circle.
Ah. We're back with Monday Night Raw! And we hear the laugh of the Million Dollar Man. Here comes Money Incorporated.
Coming down the aisle.
Many of you were with us last week when there was a little dissension between the Beverly Brothers and Money Incorporated. The Beverly Brothers challenged Money Incorporated. We're going to have a match of two highly undesirable tag teams right here on Monday Night Raw.
What a tag team's going to these guys.
If you tax cheats didn't pay your taxes on April 15th, don't think for 1 second that you're going to get an extension, because you're not.
And here they come.
From Shaker Heights, Ohio, at a total combined weight of 529 pounds, Bull and Blake, the Beverly Brothers.
Bull and Blake, the Beverly Brothers, 2 weeks ago, squared off against the Steiners. What a match that was. The Steiner Brothers coming out on top. Just last week, the Beverly Brothers offered their advice to Money Incorporated. Money Incorporated took their advice and could not defeat Scotty Steiner in single competition. Hence, after that, a melee ensued. And look out, here we go.
No, bottom line, it really doesn't matter how it happened. The Beverly Brothers got a chance of a lifetime non-title match against the champions.
Look at this, they're going at it. All four individuals, and no one really cares who wins this matchup, I don't think.
The Beverly Brothers do win Money Incorporated.
Yeah, they sure do.
Money Incorporated's going to be Chapter 11 by the end of this one, Vince.
Perhaps so. No question, the Beverlys have everything to win. If they defeat Money Incorporated here tonight on Monday Night Raw, they are in contention for the championship.
Absolutely.
Listen to the Irwin chant. What a match just last week. Irwin R. Scheister squaring off against Scotty Steiner. Athleticism at its highest degree.
Monday Night Raw, big showdown. Bad day at Black Rock. Only one tag team will survive.
Owen, Blake, the Beverly Brothers. And it looks like it's going to be Blake to start things off here.
Who do you think is going to win this match, Bartlett?
Oh, yeah, let's go to Rambling Rob Bartlett here with his expertise.
The Beverly Hillbillies.
I see.
Sorry, I asked.
And no doubt, as the match progresses, the analysis of Rob Bartlett becomes sharper and sharper.
It's coming to a point, I think.
Bit of a reversal here by the Million Dollar Man. And likewise again by Bo Beverly. No, that's Blake in there.
What kind of style would you say this is?
Kind of a style?
Freestyle hip-hop?
Hip-hop? There you go. He's right there, folks. I think maybe that last week that interview took an awful lot out of Mr. Bartlett.
Well, I don't know about that, Dave, but...
That's Vince.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, but before that interview happened, he wasn't doing too good either.
Oh! Ted DiBiase having his problems. And Blake slamming the Million Dollar Man back up to his feet. Oh, nice tag, and from the top rope down across the arm.
Big match for the purple and white. Beverly Brothers are doing the thing on Monday Night Raw.
No matter where he looks, he sees stars.
DiBiase is having his problems. Oh, how about this? Now, this is what tag team is all about.
Maybe that's what they were trying to tell the Money Incorporated to do against the Steiners.
And again, perhaps the Beverly Brothers gave Money Incorporated bad advice intentionally.
Very good. I think that's what it was. Yeah, very sharp, the Beverly Brothers.
You don't think they had ulterior motives, do you, Vince?
Oh, no, not the Beverly Brothers.
You're a little naive, aren't you, Bartlett?
Bartlett, naive?
No.
Not after last week, he's not naive.
I know it. That's why you've arrived.
Thanks.
Hey, by the way, did you and Sherry go out after the matches last week?
No, we didn't.
How's that?
Gee, well, I don't want to get into it right now.
How about now?
She beat me up, Vince.
Really?
I got beat up by a girl.
That's surprising.
Oh, no, Sensational Sherry is certainly no ordinary girl. For that matter, neither is Luna Vachon. Miss Vachon referring to herself as a woman of the 90s, as I recall last week.
And Bartlett is no ordinary guy.
Well, you've got that right.
Thank you, Randy.
And DiBiase trying to make the tag to Irwin R. Scheister. And if DiBiase cannot make the tag soon, I believe the Beverly Brothers... Uh-oh, there it is. Wait a minute, I don't think the official did not see it.
Ooh.
And look at this. Where's the official seeing this double team behind his back?
Is Irwin hot or is Irwin hot?
When Luna says she's a woman of the 90s, does that mean, like, her IQ?
You're going to have to ask Luna about that, if you dare. How about the pipes on Luna? I mean, very seldom I've ever heard a woman speak in bass or baritone.
I was waiting for her head to start spinning around.
I think maybe that's next. Sensational Sherry, I believe, has her hands full with Luna Vachon.
Never trust a chick that's got a voice lower than that.
Yeah. I'd like to hear Luna say,
"Ooh, yeah. Ooh, no."
You can bet the Steiner brothers are looking on with great interest in this matchup. All of the tag teams in the WWF, the head shrinkers as well.
That tag will not be legal right there. He had his foot on the bottom rope. Stop him.
Well, the official apparently.
There you go.
That's right.
I know my rules. I just don't follow them.
Not when you can get away with it, huh? Uh-oh, and DiBiase, shoulder to the buckle.
Tell you what, Money Incorporated have their problems right now.
And the nose to the grindstone.
So to speak.
To the buckle. And oh my, what an elbow by Ted DiBiase. Blake is almost off his feet. He is now down to the canvas. And here comes Irwin R. Scheister.
Boy, is he glad he's in there.
Oh, missing with the elbow. Very impressed thus far with the tag team coordination of the Beverly Brothers.
Absolutely. Those guys, they deserve a shot at it. I don't care if they got it through devious means, but they're wrestling a couple of devious guys.
They better file for reorganization, Money Inc. They're all over the place.
You're not in a position to give advice right now, Bart.
And again, another tag. And down across the shoulder. Once again in this matchup, Bo Beverly and Rubinar Scheister. Final card takedown, count of two and almost a count of three.
That's infuriating.
The Beverly Brothers last week challenging Money Incorporated. And who would you say this capacity crowd is behind? Or don't they care? Maybe they want to see both teams lose.
I think it's 51 to 49, but I can't call it. It's too close.
Well, that's a match you never thought you'd see on Monday Night Raw, that's for sure. Of course, then again, we never thought we'd see Rob Bartlett in his underwear last week. Look at this. Behind the referee's back.
Both teams are going to do anything they can to win this match. A big, big match.
Oh, my. Nip and tuck back and forth. And we'll be back as the matchup continues. Rubinar Scheister back to the corner.
We're back with our Monday Night Raw. We are live.
Listen to this Irwin chant again. That pole could very easily front face lock develop into a choke. And that might be what we have here.
Come on, Ralph, turn around. Now, how could Ted DiBiase have tagged Irwin R. Scheister? Let's see how sharp this official is. Oh, give me a break.
Come on.
Desperate men do desperate things, and they want to hold on to them titles even though it's a non-title match.
This referee went to the same school Rob Bartlett did. Same grammar school. Why? I
where they
got
stopped
the three.
Their formal education.
Bartlett may never be the same after last week.
Really?
And it looks
not
like
what? Ted DiBiase and Irwin R. Scheister may never be the same after this matchup.
Sure, it's going to be a clean break. No one expected that.
Ooh.
There's nothing wrong with me, Vince. No, of course not.
There's nothing right with you either.
Well,
Ted DiBiase setting up Bo Beverly. Just about all Bo Beverly had was right there. The kick to the chest area that was effective. And now, here comes Irwin R. Scheister.
Doctor said I might have a little bit of a memory loss. But Doctor said I might have a little bit of a memory loss. But
he heard you the first time.
What did you have to say?
What a matchup. Again, a match we never thought we would see on Monday Night Raw. It's a cut.
Uncensored.
And
yeah, you got it.
You got the
said I might have a little bit of a memory loss.
I think you got a memory loss.
Back body drop, no. Nice neck breaker.
Turning point of the match right now. Both guys are down. Who can make the tag to the faster guy?
Bo. Backing up, looking to tag his partner, Blake. I think he's going to make it.
First of all, you got to go to the right corner.
Yeah, the right corner would help. Yes, here we go. Ted DiBiase now. Ooh, my, receiving it of a headbutt. DiBiase set up, coming out to ropes, and back, body drop. Blake Beverly, all over the $1 million man.
Now, why would he tag Bo back in?
He didn't look like he wanted to come in right there, you know.
Bo has to be exhausted for the cover!
Oh, buddy, almost pinned him. Like I said, good idea.
I guess so.
What?
Ted DiBiase. Off the rope, elbow. Finding the mark. The Beverly Brothers now unquestionably with the momentum. A victory here would catapult them into tag team contention. Again, another back body drop.
Tell you, I'm looking for an upset right now.
Another cover to it.
Irwin R. Scheister right there.
Uh-oh, look out.
All right, make it happen.
Now the double team. The setup. Ted DiBiase. Roll to run.
Oh, no.
We saw something similar to that last week. One, two, and three gets it.
doctor said I might have a little bit of a memory loss, so.
No kidding, that's amazing. The Hitman, Bret Hart, has a loss, all right, and he's going to talk about it when we return with more WWF action on Monday Night Raw.
Gentlemen, my guest at this time, the former World Wrestling Federation champion, and many would say unquestionably the people's champion. Would you please welcome the Hitman, Bret Hart?
The people's champion. Go get him, Hitman!
Yeah!
Can't keep a good man down.
And Bret, it was approximately 2 weeks ago when you stepped into the ring at WrestleMania, yet another standing ovation. But when you stepped into the ring at WrestleMania, you were wearing the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt. Unquestionably, you knew as you faced this 400-plus pounder, that 500-plus pounder, that you were the underdog.
Well, you know, it's not the first time I've been an underdog. I think pretty much my entire career, I think I've always walked in the ring for some reason. I've always been an underdog. And being the World Wrestling Federation champion was a very, very challenging thing for me. And I felt almost always when I went in the ring, somehow I ended up always being an underdog. And for some reason, I kind of like that. I like going in the ring as an underdog. And this won't be the first time. I know a lot of people think that the Hitman's done, that I'm finished, this is as high as I'm ever gonna go.
No way.
But I don't think they could be more wrong, because I've won and I've lost before. I've lost the World Tag Team titles twice. I've lost the Intercontinental title twice. And I can remember all kinds of people, all the skeptics saying, he's finished, he's done, that's as good as the Hitman's ever gonna get. Well, they were all wrong. And they're all wrong this time. Let me ask you something. Do I look like a beaten man?
No way.
I feel just a little bit naked, that's all. But I want everybody to know one thing. I believe in myself and I believe in my fans, and I'm gonna go straight right back up to the top. And the first thing I can do is make myself a little hit list. And that's what I got. And the very first guy on my hit list is the narcissist, Lex Luger.
Right.
Yeah.
Now you're talking about someone running up to you and nailing you in the side of the head on the day of the biggest match of my entire lifetime. And I don't want to even give the narcissist credit for any of that. He wants to go around telling everybody that he cost me the title. Well, we'll see all about that, because Lex Luger, the narcissist, is the number one first guy priority on my hit list.
Well, Bret, there is an investigation, as you know, in terms of the forearm, a rather controversial forearm, and you were knocked unconscious at that WrestleMania brunch.
Well, I've never been knocked out like that before, and I've never been, I've been hit with elbows. It sort of comes with the job. You get hit with elbows all the time, but I have never, ever been hit with an elbow that hard, and I think Jack Tunney should put some kind of an investigation into that elbow, because I think there's a little more to it than bone. Let me put it that way.
What will it take for you to once again realize your dream? What will it take for you once again to be World Wrestling Federation champion?
It's gonna take for me to start out like I did before. I'm going to take the narcissist. I'm going to show him that this isn't bodybuilding. This is wrestling. And when he steps in the ring with me, he will be stepping in the ring with the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. And then as far as the rest of them go, Yokozuna and even the immortal Hulk Hogan, just remember one thing. The Hitman is coming straight right back up to the top to get back what's rightfully his.
All right.
Federation title.
Oh, Hitman, yeah. Bret Hart, former World Wrestling Federation champion, perhaps once again to wear the crown.
Let him, baby, Hitman.
We are back with more Monday Night Raw.
Uncooked.
Uncensored and uncut. And last week, undressed.
About to come down.
Sure,
TZ.
TZ didn't interview Bret the Hitman Hart. He didn't tear your shirt.
390 pounds. Bam, Bam, Bigelow.
Bam, Bam, the beast from the east.
Look at Bam Bam, look at the Raw girl.
Bill Apollo beating this monster of a man.
Bam, 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 bam.
All right, strategy session here. Let's get the word from Rob Bartlett. Our strategist for this matchup, if you're Phil Apollo, what do you do against Bam Bam Bigelow, you being the technical advisor and all that?
Well, you start thinking about who your next of kin is.
I beg your pardon?
Or are.
Whoa! To the rope, look at that, off, and Bam Bam! And Apollo, off the rope, and Bam Bam! Down again. Now what is he thinking about, Rob?
Saying his prayers.
All right.
How about the word upset?
Anything can happen here in the WWF.
It sure usually does.
Bam Bam off the rope again, and went a little high, headhunting there on Phil Apollo.
This guy can miss you and get you.
Yeah, I suppose he can. Snapmare. Big Bam Bam in control. Oh, my. Like to have your head turned around?
So my imagination, or is the competition just keep getting better and better and better? What about Briar Ferguson?
Why did they debut last week? Bam Bam taking exception to some of the remarks made from the ringside fans. Or was that you, Bartlett?
Did he take a vow of anything, Briar Ferguson?
I don't know, but Bam Bam missing. Now Apollo has an opportunity. Oh, are you kidding me?
That's the way to counter a drop kick. I never thought of that.
Yeah, but you can't very well do it unless you're Bam Bam's size. An awesome maneuver here by Bam Bam Bigelow. Turned a defensive line into an offensive line. Bam Bam. And oh my!
Who's the clown in the stands?
Wait a minute, there is. Is that coming up? I believe. Is that Doink over in the far side? We can't see him very well. Yes! What's he doing here? Oh, look at that. Spraying some of the fans at ringside. Bam Bam Bigelow, meanwhile, on the inside, is having as much fun as Doink is on the outside. Apollo for the ride. Yeah. What a ride it's been thus far.
And the good news, there's only one Doink.
So far.
You're right about that. I like to stay positive as long as I can.
Now,
not a pretty face, not a pretty face.
Is he just schizophrenic?
I have no idea. I don't think I want to know too much about Doink. We saw two Doinks at WrestleMania. It was not an illusion. David Copperfield is clever, but I don't believe he's quite that clever.
If Bam Bam wasn't sitting here, I think it would be him maybe Doink.
Apollo hanging in the match. You have to hand it to Apollo. He's hanging in there against big, rugged Bam Bam Bigelow, the beast from the east. Apollo whipped to the far side. Here comes Bam Bam moving in. Oh! And this time, Apollo takes the full brunt of Bam Bam Bigelow.
That was like a 10-car collision right there.
But if you looked up Brunt in the dictionary, you'd see Bam Bam's picture.
Bam Bam with Apollo right where he wants him. And look at this. Painful hold here. The official right there. If this is going to be a submission or could very well easily develop into a chokehold, doesn't matter. He's down to the canvas anyhow.
That was strength and leverage at the same time. A dangerous combination.
Very dangerous.
Phil, listen to me, babe. Ooh. Well done.
See?
Tell you what,
when you count Phil Apollo out, he's coming back. Right hand kick to the guts there. Ooh. Oh, my.
Apollo's already a winner in my book. The longer this match goes, he's done the thing. Against all odds.
Hanging in there all the way against Bam Bam Bigelow. Oh, my. Can you imagine the impact? Oh! Yeah, about it.
I think we can say goodbye right now.
Yeah, right after that. No one's going to get up after that.
That was more raw than raw.
Oh, no. Well, I don't know. We may have to send for the scraper to get Phil Apollo up after this. Bam Bam Bigelow going up. Bam Bam Bigelow going up to the top rope. Bam Bam now.
Incoming.
Oh. Unbelievable. And a count of three. Bam Bam Bigelow victorious. Let's take you back. Here we go.
Air traffic control. Oh. Get out of the way, Apollo. You didn't do it. And that's the end of story.
Wait a minute. There. Let's come back up here. Wait a minute. I think he's going to do it again.
No.
Bam Bam on the top rope. Apollo has hurt it. Bam Bam. Oh.
That was not a replay. That was live.
Now, come on, what kind of competitor is this?
Not only the winner, the sole survivor.
Whoa, 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 wait a minute. Hey. Fryer Ferguson is, what's he doing, coming out?
Fryer, you better bless this guy.
We saw him last week. Fryer Ferguson coming over to help out Mr. Apollo, and I think Bam Bam was gonna go up again for yet a third leap from the top. And Fryer Ferguson is saying no. Ferguson with a rather auspicious debut last week, and now he's certainly not afraid to come out here.
Oh.
Wait a minute.
Tell you what, I'm confused right now. I'll tell you the bottom line.
Oh, I think Fryer Ferguson means business. He's not afraid to mix it up with Bam Bam Bigelow. He's not afraid at all. Cut himself shaving this morning, but he's not afraid to mix it up with Bam Bam.
That can happen to anyone.
Well, drop kick, look at that. Yes! And time for a little nip. Good job, Fryer.
Hey there, I'm Bart.
And I'm Billy.
You know, me and my partner have been riding together for a lot of years, and we're fixing to ride into the WWF to face the good, the bad, and the ugly. And you know, when it's all said and done, me and my partner, Bart, be riding tall in the saddle.
Yeah! Yeah!
From inside the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gorilla Monsoon for Update. Brought to you by Coliseum Home Video, where WrestleMania 9 with all its action and excitement is now available. And don't forget, with Coliseum Home Video, you get all that exclusive behind-the-scenes action and excitement. Get this, folks. Since entering the World Wrestling Federation, Lex Luger has literally knocked out every one of his opponents with a devastating forearm. And at WrestleMania 9, not only did he knock out his opponent, Mr. Perfect, but earlier on in the day, at a brunch, he knocked out then reigning WWF champion, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Another factor that we should be concerned about later today, in the corner of Yokozuna, not other than Mr. Perfect.
Oh. Hey. Hey! Oh, my God!
the events at WrestleMania 9, President Jack Tunney's office launched a complete investigation into the forearm of Lex Luger. The investigation consisted of a complete physical and x-rays of that forearm. Get this, folks, the x-rays showed that Luger does indeed have a steel plate in the forearm area just below the elbow. This plate was surgically implanted following a motorcycle accident. Because it is considered to be part of his anatomy, Jack Tunney's office is now powerless to do anything about that implant, even though it gives an unfair advantage to Lex Luger. Here's what Luger had to say.
Is it fair that I look the way I do and all of you look the way you do? And is it fair that this world-famous elbow had a steel plate implanted into it after a motorcycle accident and Jack Tunney can't do anything about it? And is it fair that I knocked Bret the Hitman Hart out at the WrestleMania brunch and he proceeded to lose his title? Well, maybe not, but you know, life just isn't fair. Unless, of course, you're the narcissist, Lex Luger.
Obviously, Lex Luger very happy about the situation, but guys like Bret the Hitman Hart, folks, you can bet your bottom dollar, are not. And he'll have a whole lot to say about this in the very near future. Nobody likes to be knocked out, especially by the likes of Lex Luger. For Update, this has been Gorilla Monsoon.
I thought it was the greatest thing. Look,
the following contest is scheduled.
Hey, now, wait a minute. Just because you're upset over this King of the Ring thing, it doesn't give you any right to make statements and comments like that.
Don't remind me of that. I'd almost gotten that off my mind.
Here is
Tatanka get scalped.
Mr.
How about that?
Hughes.
The Indian got scalped. The tables are turned.
And his
it was great.
Let me tell you all something.
What?
There's going to be TCB take care of business, and the kickoff is going to be Monday Night Raw. I don't even like President Jack Tunney's decision about the narcissist. The big Hawaiian punch man crush is going to take Lex Luger and take him all the way down on Raw, and I'm sure Bam Bam's going to get what he deserves, and that's a Tatanka hangover.
Is he through?
I'm done. I said what I said, and I'm glad.
You've talked so much, your tonsils need to be retreaded. Now just sit over there and shut up.
Well, this man is very, very impressive in the ring right now. Curtis Hughes. Mr. Hughes, and there are many managers throughout the World Wrestling Federation who would like to have the opportunity to manage Curtis Hughes.
And rightly so. This guy can make somebody a lot of money.
Awesome individual. Standing by, so we are told now, is the manager of the 8-foot giant.
Oh, Mr. Hughes, what a specimen. He reminds me a lot of myself. Tough, strong, and not afraid of anything. Well, Mr. Hughes, of all the managers in the World Wrestling Federation, Whippleman can do the most for you.
Do you agree with that, Macho Man?
I'm not saying nothing about nothing for a couple of seconds. I'm trying to cool off, get calm.
Well, if you always said what was on your mind, you'd be speechless anyway.
I didn't even hear
that.
Would
you guys please?
That's all right, Vince McMahon.
I mean, what's going on here? Jack Tunney, in my view, makes a lousy decision.
Exactly.
Here we've got Tatanka with all kind of shenanigans going on back in the dressing room area. I mean, a King of the Ring tournament. What's going on here in the WWF? We got guys trying to manage Mr. Hughes. Everybody wants to manage him. The King, Jerry Lawler, all upset over this King of the Ring tournament.
And now you haven't heard the last of that yet either. But let's concentrate on Mr. Hughes a minute. You know, this guy is a former bodyguard. This guy was the original bodyguard to Whitney Houston. And then some wimp came along and stole his part in the movie, Kevin Costner. They should have used Mr. Hughes. Well, he was their bodyguard.
As far as his athletic background is concerned, he's a former high school All-American.
Right.
Played 4 years on the defensive squad for Kansas State.
A real university now, not like Michigan.
Uh-huh. In any event, he is a big, bad hombre. No wonder managers throughout the WWF are taking a good, long look at Curtis Hughes.
Watch this. Take a good, long look at this.
Wow. Nice suplex. Big, strong, powerful, mean man. He means business in the squared circle, and he's just not finished with his opponent at the moment. And I'll tell you what's not finished. That business between Bam Bam Bigelow and Tatanka.
You can see that again.
Why do you say it's not finished? You think Tatanka hadn't had enough?
I think it's only beginning. However, this match is history.
which you might be able to say Bam Bam's career is going to be history.
Oh, no. I was so glad to see Bam Bam do that. Didn't little Big Horn get you guys upset? Tommy got a little revenge.
Let's take you to the event center.
Hey, Mr. Perfect. Next week, it's me and you in a big qualifying match for the King of the Ring. And as you well know, I am on a roll. One thing I want to know, do you have perfect vision? Or will you have double vision?
Doink, don't concern yourself with my vision, because next week right here, the winner of this match qualifies for the King of the Ring tournament. The only thing you have to be concerned about, Doink, is how you're going to get around Mr. Perfect.
That's Blake Beverly, right?
Well, Bo may be around. You never know.
And this, of course, is Mr. Perfect.
I caught him that trick.
Oh, you did?
Yes, I did.
Well, I know one thing. He is excited about next weekend, because on WWF Superstars, Mr. Perfect will take on Doink the Clown in a qualifying match for the King of the Ring tournament.
Well, I suggest Mr. Perfect stays home during that match, because he's not going to defeat Doink. Doink really knows how to wrestle. Then again, so does Perfect. But I think Doink's got the edge here.
And Blake Beverly getting the early advantage on Mr. Perfect attacking him. And
you know that old saying, you whip by the towel, you die by the towel.
Well, he's choking him with it, that's for sure right here. And almost an airplane spin using the towel for leverage.
Very good. Very good, Blake. Excellent.
Hard forearm to the back of the head. Blake Beverly follows it with a headbutt, and down goes Mr. Perfect. Double axe handle to the spine, and Blake Beverly showing a tremendous amount of offense here in the early going, as Mr. Perfect having a hard time getting out of the blocks.
You know what I'm concerned with is Blake and Bo Beverly are a tag team. They've been together all their lives, naturally, but they've wrestled together all their lives. I don't know how many single matches he's had, so this should be interesting.
The Irish whip to the center of the ropes is reversed. And tremendous shoulder block by Mr. Perfect. Perfect has a full agenda these days. Certainly has a score to settle with Shawn Michaels. And as being a former two-time Intercontinental Champion, I'm sure that Perfect would love the opportunity to regain that championship once again.
And you know what, Perfect's ego, he wants that title. He wants the money. He wants the prestige. But above all that, he would just love to stick it to Shawn Michaels and walk around with Shawn Michaels' Intercontinental belt on.
Great drop kick by Mr. Perfect. And Blake Beverly goes all the way outside.
You know, you can't take it away from him. Uh-oh, here comes Bo.
Bo Beverly in the ring. Trying a cheap shot there. And he's elevated for his trouble.
Now, is that Bo or Blake? Tremendous athlete. Second generation. He knows almost everything there is to know and how to survive in that ring. But without me, that mind just doesn't work. That's what makes him perfect when I was with him.
Well, the referee, I think, may be sending Bo Beverly back to the locker room.
Well, he's got a right to be there.
How do you figure that? He's not a manager.
Well, he's his other brother.
He doesn't have a manager's license.
He doesn't have to. He's his other brother.
Well, I don't know about that.
Whoa.
Oh, man. Blake Beverly drops Mr. Perfect, and there goes Bo back to the showers.
I imagine he'll be fined some money for that.
I think that would be appropriate. Neck breaker.
Come on, Blake, cover him. Get on him. 2, 6, 7, 8, 9. See, you can't waste time like that with Mr. Perfect. He'll snap it right away from you.
He is very resilient, as we all know. Irish whip.
But he's an ingrate.
Oh, boy, it's a clothesline. The cross body. And got a near fall there. 2 count. Beverly back up very quickly. Trying to regain the advantage here. A stomp right to the abdomen.
You own a pickup truck?
You better believe it.
Why?
I like a truck. What's wrong with a truck? What do you drive?
I have a chauffeur. I don't drive.
Excuse me.
Her name's Jennifer.
Blake Beverly now has reasserted himself offensively here, controlling the tempo.
Try to drive some time from the back seat. It's not easy. You can't do that in a pickup truck.
Well, you got a point there. You're right. But
I guess just move the hay over, huh?
I can't afford a chauffeur. Beverly trying to go for a suplex, but it's good move there by Mr. Perfect. He hooked the front face lock in and then reversed the suplex from Blake Beverly.
See, now I would have told him to go right for the perfect plex, but he didn't.
Hard forward to the lower back. We know that Mr. Perfect has had some problems with his back in years past.
No. I've had trouble with my back. That's where they found the knife that Perfect put in it.
I think your version of your association with Mr. Perfect is certainly exclusive to you. That's not how I hear the story.
Oh. Yeah, but you're hearing it from a liar. You can believe me, Ross. I'm not going to lie to you, pal. I'm your buddy. You know that.
Yeah, oh, sure. I really know that by now. After a few weeks with you. Another kick to the midsection.
Knee whip.
Blake Beverly has looked very impressive offensively here. Catches Perfect with a knife-edge shot.
Nail him again.
And even though Perfect...
See, now, I think he's wasting time. You gotta stay on Perfect. You can't give him... Uh-oh.
And Perfect blocks the right hand, comes back with a right of his own. Oh. And a big chop, and down goes Blake Beverly. Here comes the Irish whip. It's reversed. And Perfect...
Oh, he's got it!
He hooks it. Can he get him? Yes! He got the complex! He's got the legs!
Get
out! Tremendous offensive move by Mr. Perfect! Shawn Michaels, best beware!
I'm sure he hooked the tights! I'm sure he was!
He had his hands hooked! What a victory for Mr. Perfect! And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the event center!
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week is the most menacing force ever to enter the World Wrestling Federation. He is the narcissist, Lex Luger.
I love his music. I love his entrance. Is he proud of himself?
Oh, yeah. He's arrogant.
Does he love himself?
I've seen it. Oh, he does. You're exactly right.
He has the right to.
Well, he's walking around with a steel plate in his right forearm, and that's certainly going to give him an advantage over anyone that he competes with. He ought to have some type of brace or something. He ought to be made to wear some type of padding on that right forearm.
Quit making excuses. You're just jealous.
He's so happy that he's in front of a mirror.
Conduct the interview when he's ready. I'm gonna have to wait. Eat your heart out, Toots.
Well, he is an awesome athlete and obviously has a phenomenal physique, but his attitude is pathetic.
All right, Lex Luger, you have been knocking out opponents left and right with that.
Excuse me, make yourself useful. Just for one moment, and here, hold this while I admire myself.
He knows what he likes.
As I was saying, you have been knocking everybody out with that surgically implanted steel plate in your forearm. Why? Why, you have accumulated more knockouts than Muhammad Ali, Joe Frazier, George Foreman and Mike Tyson combined. it is unanimous with everyone that you have an unfair advantage over everybody else here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Did you say unfair? Unfair? Is it fair that each and every day of my life I have to look out at people like this? The genetically shortchanged, you know who I'm talking about. You fat, disgusting people with rolls and globs of fat hanging from your waist. You know what I'm talking about? Oh, you fat, disgusting, cellulite-ridden women with cottage cheese hanging off the back of your legs. Oh, you short people. Try to look like me, but you never will. And is it fair? And speaking of being disgusted, Bret Hart, you totally disgust me, because I was disgusted with you when at the WrestleMania brunch I knocked you unconscious and you laid at my feet in a curled up fetal position. And I said to myself, is this the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion laying here unconscious? And is it fair, Bret Hart, that because of me, you are no longer the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion? And you know, as disgusting as it is for all of you to look in the mirror every day, I relish it. And Bret the Hitman Hart, I know that you're disgusted when you look in the mirror, because you know that your days are numbered, because when you step into the ring with the narcissist Lex Luger, your career will be terminated. Give me that back.
See Luger and Bret Hart. I think he's going to pay for everything he just said when he takes on the Hitman. Vance, we'll be back with more. Oh, he disgusts me.
Well, in my opinion,
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Lex Luger and I are in a match to qualify for the King of the Ring tournament. And Lex Luger, I know you very well. You've worked hard all your life. You're very strong, you're very determined, and you like yourself tremendously. We're going to get into that ring and see who comes out victorious.
Mr. Backlund, I have to agree with you. I am incredible, but tell me something I don't already know. But being the likable sort of fellow that you are, I'm going to make it as quick and painless as possible for you next week. Can you imagine them making me qualify? That's pathetic.
Would Vince McMahon and
Ladies
the Intercontinental
and gentlemen,
Champion.
My guest at this time, the reigning Intercontinental Champion, would you please welcome Shawn Michaels.
Oh, yeah. Shawn Michaels.
There he is.
Do you look good or not?
Self-proclaimed the Heartbreak Kid.
Here's looking at you, Shawn Michaels. You know, Savage, he may be the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time.
I like when you say the word may. I think Mr. Perfect was bottom line.
Well, you're wrong. Wrong about that. Heartbreak Kid, yeah. Coming back at you, pal.
Mr. Michaels, we have your attention, please. There's no doubt that sooner or later your path is going to cross that of Mr. Perfect, but we'll talk about that in just a moment. Right here next week, you defending the Intercontinental Championship against Hacksaw Jim Duggan. What What possesses you to put the title on the line knowing that Mr. Perfect is breathing down your neck?
First of all, I want to tell you how sick and tired I am of having to come to this dump, New York City. I mean, this place is like the armpit of the nation. Now, even my armpit isn't that bad. You know, I saw those same two guys on TV doing some kind of a march in Washington. Way to go, guys. Anyway.
Amazing that you would come out here and insult these wonderful fans in New York and all over the world that stand behind many of the superstars in the WWF. I guess maybe you're just not worthy of that.
You know, you see this, Vin Man? This is the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental title. I don't need anybody to stand behind me. I got this on my own. And speaking of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the man who doesn't know if he's coming or going.
Huh, you only knew how sharp Mr. Michaels
Duggan,
is.
Duggan, Shawn Michaels is an equal opportunity defender. It doesn't matter if you're short, fat, big, or tall, or in your case, ugly, as the day is long.
What they're doing
Everybody
is shouting, Shawn is great. Shawn is great.
We'll get short.
How can you ignore this Shawn capacity crowd?
Great.
Listen to him.
Shawn
How can you ignore
him? Buy it. Shawn
These people
great.
Mean absolutely nothing to me.
He's sweating.
I don't have time in my life for a bunch of losers.
Shawn is great.
Like these Shawn idiots
is great. All right, let's talk about Mr. Perfect. Let's talk about, well, sort of a collision course there that you had with Mr. Perfect at WrestleMania. You will recall you and the narcissist Lex Luger were behind the locker room area outside, actually, and congratulating
Shawn
each
Michaels
other, I believe.
Michaels,
and,
Michaels,
well, there was a little problem, wasn't there?
Mr. Perfect.
A cheap shot.
Yes,
oh,
Mr.
Perfect.
Man.
Mr.
Perfect.
What a cheap shot
Perfect.
In this
Perfect.
Attack by Michaels.
Oh, you mean Grover.
Beg your pardon?
Grover. You mean Mr. Grover? The guy that lives in the trash can on Sesame Street? The guy that I put in the trash can?
Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect, I got news for you. Perfect, you are gonna stay right.
Uh-oh. Hey, I like it. That's right. We're gonna have some fun now, Savage. He's in trouble now.
Go for it.
Oh, you were right. Perfect is in trouble. McMahon's bailing out.
Perfect situation where Shawn Michaels doesn't want any part of Mr. Perfect. Everybody behind Perfect right now, Brain. Ooh, a cheap shot. Look at that. Get him, Perfect. Get him.
Perfect going after Shawn Michaels will be.